everybody. You know, I tried to do this live yesterday while I was waiting for my ride home from work. And apparently YouTube Live or Google Hangouts, whatever you want to call it, this live streaming wasn't working. Apparently there was something wrong. I thought at first it was maybe my phone, maybe something was up there, but no, it was something on YouTube's side because everything was working fine. Everything was good. But apparently YouTube had some issues with the streaming or something. But I wanted to come out, and I will provide a link down below so you guys can check it out yourselves. But I wanted to come out, and I want to do a bit of an MLP web comic recommendation. Now, this is, you could probably say it's not much of a web comic, seeing as though it's done by a fan, but it's 20 pages worth, and I think it's worth checking out. You know, because here's the thing. Lately, over the past few months, a lot of people have been asking about the whole Rarity and Spike relationship. Like, you know, some people have been asking at the MLP forums and any other fan community message boards. Basically, fans have been asking, you know, will it occur again? Will it happen again? Will it be addressed? Will it end? And to me, I've come to the solution that if you're going to do this, and if you're going to give this any kind of clarification, if you're going to kind of put a icing on the cake for this, if you will, a cherry on top, if you're going to put any kind of, I guess you could say, satisfactory ending to this, then to me, the best thing to do, and I made this suggestion at the MLP forums on audio and all that, that the best thing to do is do an episode down the line where this gets addressed. Maybe you do it to the point that, you know, Spike gets Twilight to cast a spell on him that turns him temporarily into a pony, into a stallion pony, whatever, who goes out on a date with Rarity. Because the synopsis that I would come up with is it's Spike's birthday again, but instead of chancing the fact that he might get greedy and you know, repeating what we saw in The Secret of My Excess, that instead his real one wish, his one goal, his one wish that he's always wanted is to go out with Rarity on a date, and, you know, is to go out with Rarity and not just to go pick out gems and all that, but to actually go on a date with her, spend some quality time, you know, having fun, you know, going to a show or going to dinner or whatever. And that even though it'd be a one-time deal and it may not be addressed again, at least from a fan perspective, you know, the writers would at least have addressed this and at least kind of left the door open to the fact that, yes, there is probably something there between Rarity and Spike, probably that goes beyond friendship. But, you know, again, you have a dividing fan base, because the fan base is kind of like, yeah, you could do that, but would it work? Would it achieve its goal? And that's a good question. You know, some have been disparaging about it, like it wouldn't work. It doesn't make sense. It's not right. Stuff like that. So, you know, so you basically got a mixed reaction from a lot of fans. You know, some are okay with it. Some are kind of not okay with it. Some are mixed about it, and some are like me. You know, do something that kind of acknowledges. That at least acknowledges that you know about the fans' support for it, the fans' embracing of it, and, you know, at least do something that says, yeah, we know about it. Here's an episode that, you know, it's sort of like pays homage to it, kind of gets it out of the way, da da da. So that was my thought process. Then lo and behold, one day, back actually about a day or two ago, I'm looking on Google. I just put in Sparity for the heck of it, Rarity and Spike. And up comes a lot of the rarity and spike images that we all know of. And a lot of links to certain DeviantArt groups, websites, and stuff like that. And then I saw this one link to a DeviantArt thing. There's something on DeviantArt called Change of Heart. And I was like, what is this? So I clicked on it. And what Change of Heart is a 20-page MLP webcomic that this fan did. And basically, when I read it, I was like, oh my gosh, this is almost identical to what I had described. The only difference was Spike was the one that cast a spell on himself, Elf, and basically Rarity kind of knew it was him, but didn't let on until the end of the date. Now, my synopsis on this, my original synopsis, if they were to do an episode, is to have, like I said, have Twilight cast a spell, have Twilight kind of let Rarity know that this is what Spike wants to do, you know, have Rarity kind of agree to it, but also voice the same concern that Spike would have, that people would look at the fact that they're both a dragon and a pony, and, you know, that wouldn't maybe look right in the eyes of some. So have Twilight basically, like I say, temporarily turn Spike into a pony or stallion, and then have her bring Rarity out of her boutique, covering her eyes a little bit with her, I guess, magic or something like that. And then having her open her eyes and see the now tonified Spike right in front of her, saying this is basically presenting the temporary solution to how they can go out. And that's, there you go. But like I said, the difference here, though, is it was Spike that had cast a spell on himself in this webcomic, and that Rarity at first didn't recognize him, but felt there was something something familiar about him, something that was kind of familiar. And then you kind of, there's a panel where she kind of gets this thought bubble. She has the image of Spike in the thought bubble, and she's like, it's like, oh, you little rascal. She says it in the webcomic. She calls him a little rascal in her thoughts. She's like, you little rascal. So, you know, there you go. And a change of heart is, to me, probably one of the, I haven't read many MLP webcomics, but if I was to recommend anyone, it's got to, anyone for starters or anybody that wants to at least try to use something as a bit of a bait or a bit of a hint and for the writers of the show, if not the comics, to say, hey, go ahead, this is what you need to go ahead, look, this can be done, this would be it. A Change of Heart would definitely be the webcomic, the fan project that I would present to someone like Megan McCarthy, M.A. Larson, the lady writers as they call themselves, who wrote the episode The Perfect Pair. I would present this to them and say, look, this is how you can go about doing it. You can change it up a little bit, but this is how you can go about doing it. And it could work. It could work. And then you don't have to worry about it anymore, because at least you've acknowledged the situation there. You've acknowledged, hey, there is something there between these two, you know, besides friendship. And this is a good solution of doing it. I mean, again, like I said, my solution is to have Twilight change him with her magic, not himself, but have her do it. And I think it could really, really work in the end. I really do. So, but overall, getting back to A Change of Heart, this is definitely a webcomic that I would suggest to anybody that's a supporter of Rarity and Spike, that is a supporter of the whole Sparity deal. For anybody that feels like, okay, we know this is a thing, you know, let's get this out of the way. We know this is a thing, but we need proof that it could actually work. This is the webcomic that I think provides that proof. And again, I believe it's a good, to me, I believe it's a good amount, even though it's 20 pages, I believe it's a good amount of proof. It's a good amount of proof to show that this can be done and that it could be adapted, if not loosely adapted, into a official issue of the comic or an official episode of the show. I think it really could. And this could be, this kind of little webcomic here, A Change of Heart, is definitely a catalyst for making that happen. Now, I will say that some of you might find the ending a little cheesy and all that, maybe. But, you know, what are you going to do with a comic like this? You need to have, you know, what are you going to do with a comic like this? You know, you need to have an ending that's, you know, cheesy and a little mushy, if you will. But I think it works. I think it actually works in the end. So, to me, I truly believe that this is a comic, a web comic, that needs to be seen to be believed. So I will provide the link down below for you guys so you can see it and enjoy it. And I believe people that maybe doubt that this will work, this is the kind of story that shows it can be done. So that's all I'm going to say for my MLP fan webcomic recommendation. I hope you guys take a look at it, you know, and give it a chance, and let me know what you guys think down below. Let the person that did this know how you feel about it down below, because I think he did a very good job on it. So that's all I'm going to say, folks. Let me know what you think down below. Comment if you like, and I am out.